All right, so the following is all the video footage I have of trying to Frankenstein this guy together. And I'm going to do a voiceover on it, unedited, of course, so we'll see how that goes. And enjoy. All right, so what do we got here? Here we got me having fused the legs together already and cut off one of the arms. And here I put the arms back and did some sculpting. I had to sculpt in the chest robe part and filled in the gaps with some epoxy. And here I sculpted some of the rips that were in it, and also I had to sculpt in the pattern and texture of the pants to make it look right. And here's the foot, which I put some more sculpt on, and I also attached a bunch of little tiny magnets, and the magnets are just there so it looks more mechanical than the Shang-Chi foot that it was. And here's, this leg is the finished leg. For the most part, it's pretty finished, and the whole paint scheme is based on Sonic Sledgehammer Studios website. I mean, not website, but YouTube channel, and where they dry brushed a minifigure of Darth Vader, and I used that as a template to do all my painting on this figure. I used the paints that he showed to use. I didn't just dry brush it though. I did more than that. And shout out to the guy at my Games Workshop who showed me how to paint that type of skin. That came out pretty good as well. And yeah, that's about it on there. And sculpted that knee with some epoxy sculpt. And let's see where we go. And oh yeah, so there's some more sculpt. I had to sculpt on that glove. And of course, one of the hands is from a Gambit, and one of the hands is from a Mezco Daredevil, and one of the, not a, what kind of Gambit? Amazing Yamaguchi Gambit. And here is a lightsaber that I was going to use, but I decided to do the, just paint it, so I can do some object source lighting against it, which I probably couldn't have done with, I'll use that one for another time. And that was the Mezco Daredevil hand. And I beat up the chest plates a little bit. And that's where the arm is going to connect with the cybernetic arm. And that hand, that's the Amazing Yamaguchi Gambit hand. And I didn't end up using that lightsaber. And you can see some of the sculpt on the leg. And there, that's some more sculpt. So I kind of went backwards in time with this video because the previous video, that one leg was complete. Now it's not. So, well, what you gonna do? And this is the other leg that's complete. I wanted to show on this leg where the cybernetic leg met with Darth Vader's actual leg. So that's why I put that sculpted that rip in there, and you can see a little bit of the gold there. That's where it meets, because I figure in all the sections that his body meets the cybernetic parts, there's a gold band around it. And I think that's what the new Mythos Darth Vader shows, a little gold band there. So that's where I got the idea from. Here you can see some of the gashes. Some of the gashes that I made with the Dremel. No, actually not the Dremel. I heated it up, and then I made all those gashes with an X-Acto knife. It was way easier. I thought it was going to be real easy with the Dremel, but it was much more easier to just cut it away with an X-Acto knife like butter once it was heated up and soft. And so this is basically just a dry brush. I'm doing a dry brush over the black base coat that I got down. And there's some of the rips that I had to sculpt into the robe part, upper robe part. And this is the arm with the, like I mentioned before, the gold band. And the first go-round for the skin, it's not the finished skin, but it's the first base paint, and then what is it called, a wash? Yeah, it's called a wash. I put a wash on it, and this is before, not completely finished, but, you know, a work in progress, basically, on the two arms. And you can see all the sculpting that I did at the bottom of the gloves, because they're kind of shredded. And here it's more so done. I
looking at it, I can't tell if this was complete. Like, the arms are complete there, but they look complete to me. So we'll call those arms and the legs completed. And definitely completed there. So if it wasn't complete last time, it's complete now. And the shin guard on that one, I wanted it to be super beat up, but to get the shin guard to look like that, I had to Dremel out the entire calf until it was nothing but that shin guard left. And then I weathered it up really good, and then I glued it to the front of the robot leg that I got from the Mandalorian robot figure. Q90, I think it's something like that. Correct me if I'm wrong. And there you can see I'm getting the buttons ready to go with a coat of silver paint. And here's the head. I thought the head was going to be more difficult than it was because it was the translucent paint. It was the translucent head. So I didn't know how the paint was going to adhere to that. But it didn't give me too much problems. And here is the Black Warbler, which was amazing. It worked out great. It was the first time ever working with that. And what I did was heat it up really good and then let gravity do most of the work. So I held the figure sideways and let it all droop down to one side, and then slowly but surely in sections I would heat up, mold it to how I wanted it curled and how I wanted it flowing, and kept going. And I didn't even have to paint it. The only paint on that cape is for the weathering and the object source lighting is the only paint I had to do. And here I was going to make the skirt out of normal Warbler. So I sculpted everything out, and this is before I used the black one on the cape though. And the cape just worked out so well that I scrapped this. I totally scrapped all these pieces and made the skirt out of the Black Warbler too. Because look, I didn't have to do any wood glue on it or nothing. I mean, it looks great. I didn't have to do nothing but form it really. And then it worked out great. I'll work with that stuff no problem again. I don't even know if I'll ever work with the other Warbler because this just worked out great. It came out better than I thought it would. All I had to do was, you know, dry brush some weathering on it. You cut with scissors and heat it up at the ends and kind of pull away to make it look ratted. But that's about it. I didn't have to paint that at all. I didn't paint that black at all. That black is how it came. And this is just a quarter of the paints I used and how messy things get when I'm in the middle of a project. So. And here's the only picture I have of, the only video I have of making that saber. And here we're getting into the base. And shout out to Euler's Workshop for showing me how to utilize floral foam, because that came great with this rock formation that I made. I mean, granted, it's really small, but priceless information came from there. And there's little bits and pieces of cork spread around there, a little cork sheet that I sprinkled around there and Mod Podged in there, and then put a white base coat over everything. And now I'm just slowly starting to build up the layers, because you know this all took much layers. And actually I went too far on this base as far as the lava goes. I thought it was perfect at one point, but then I went and took an extra one or two steps further, and it didn't need it. I'll know that for next time I do lava, because it looked great the first at one point. Here coming up this pic, see that? I should have kept it looking just like that, but I wanted to use the Woodland Scenic ripple effects on it to make it more shiny and whatnot. And I mean, it doesn't look bad, but that looked better in my opinion. And here's me trying to make it like an official you know, statue, and you know how Sideshow and Prime One be doing that to the bottom of their statues. And so when I put that inside, it didn't exactly fit around, so I had to use tissue and Mod Podge to fill in the gaps, because there were some gaps that didn't solidly go around. And now we're just gonna do some glamour shots, so enjoy these glamour shots, guys. It came out well. I really enjoyed the build. And this is my newest project. And thanks for watching, and shout out to Oilers Workshop and Sonic Sledgehammer Studios for all the information that I was able to, you know, sponge off of you guys.
And shout out to Sideshow Studios for the amazing Mythos Darth Vader statue that's up for pre-order with only a few left now, coming out next year. Needless to say, I was 100% inspired by that and what the Kucherek brothers did on that sculpt. I had no plans on doing anything like this, and then when I saw that, I was like, well, everything's gonna go on hold until I get this out of my brain. And stay tuned for more stuff that's in the pipeline and for more videos that I'm gonna upload from past projects. I'm really just starting to get used to how to edit and post stuff up so it's at least watchable, and hopefully you guys get inspired and stay creative, and until the next one.